Hello and welcome back to Unsung. We're thank you for coming. We're doing a little things a little bit different. We've done video for the past couple of shows, but I haven't put the video out because no one wants to see it. For instance, I was just air singing to the song and miming a microphone when I have a microphone in front of me. But that's the same logic that comes from the brain trust that got the utensils mixed up and gave the gave the spoon to the guy with the solid food, and I ended up eating soup with a fork, and that soup lasted forever. I never finished that soup. If you want to stretch a meal out, eat soup with a fork.
What about a spatula?
Yeah, that'll be one of our new sponsors. Soup with a fork. It'll be a diet product, and it'll help people eat. Today we're going to talk about words and importance of words, the power of the spoken words. Words can be seeds. They can be bullets. They are the most powerful thing that we've got. We just don't use them correctly, I think. They have the energy to build or destroy, to heal, to hinder, to humiliate, to humble. They do it all. Considering the powerful force beyond words, we neglect them. We don't speak. We don't communicate well. We have so many avenues to communicate, and we don't do it well. And I find that there's a people that I deal with that I find are much more interesting because they value the spoken word. It's not that you've got to use $25 words or you can use a nickel word, as Harry Truman used to say. You just got to pick your words, enunciate yourself, all those good things. The right speech used to be important. It used to matter. We've taken shortcuts with it. We do all kinds of things. On the walls of the pyramids, there are little pictures, hieroglyphics. And here we are thousands of years later, and we're sending emojis. Emojis are just modern-day hieroglyphics. We're communicating the same ways. It's all a circle. When we use the words, we should use them with mindfulness. There's a whole bunch of words that we don't use and we don't use properly. One of the things that I've noticed is that maybe we don't get the ratios down. Most words are two or three syllables long, and average person speaks between 100 and 130 words a minute. A professional, 150, 160, they can do it and still sound clear. People read about 250 words per minute on average. Some people are quicker, some people are slower, but that's the average. And there's about 250 words on a double space, 8.5 by 11 page. So using a normal font and everything, it comes out to about a minute, a page, a minute. For that many words in a reading, we can speak a page a minute roughly. That balances out. Now, we're supposed to be able to listen much faster than we can speak. But nobody, we can listen about 210 words per minute, but nobody has put anything tangible on how fast we comprehend, because listening and hearing isn't just comprehension. I think, dictation is 105 words per minute. Listening is 210, literally double. We're out of sync in some ways. So we're getting 500 words on a single space, 12-point font page. I don't know who uses 12-point fonts. I do sometimes, but usually 10. 12 is just one if you want to go wild. Double space, that 500 words turns into 250 words, which matches up with everything else. But in this process of aligning all these things so that we can communicate, so that we can, when we're dealing with each other, one person's typing, another person's, you're getting a text, you're on Messenger, you're on whatever medium you choose. There's so many choices. It used to be you called somebody on the phone and that was it. Now you have to respond to them in a way that they contact you with. And the embarrassing part is when you forget how the person contacted you. And you're like tracking down, was that on Messenger? Was it on this? Was it on that? And in that rush to communicate and compensate, we're losing a lot. The skills aren't there. We've become a bunch of mumbling and stammering, downward looking, just nincompoops that don't pay attention. There's a word that's not used a lot anymore, nincompoops. There's things that we do that devalue and diffuse and overly soften our intentions. We can be direct and to the point without being rude or offensive. I think we're overly sensitive about things. I think that sensitivity doesn't necessarily trump the right of someone to speak directly. And I found myself at times, I've been as offended by sensitivity as I have by insensitivity. They can both be offensive. It isn't on any person to put their values on someone else to restrict them. One person can't restrict everyone else. We shouldn't have it that way. It's gotten out of control. Words, phrases that weaken things. There's a bunch of them. I mean, think now. Can you think of any words that you use that you shouldn't use that weaken things? What about the word just? What about just? Where's that fall in for you? It minimizes. I just want to ask you. It's less than saying, I want to ask you. It's putting you in a unnecessarily humble spot. And I'm just saying, give up the habits of using these weakening words because they make you seem weak. Sorry. If you have to apologize, then apologize. But don't overuse the word. I mean, this could fall in multiple categories. This word is overused. Sorry, it rolls off the list. Or millennials use the phrase, which just grates my nerves, is my bad. They just throw it out there so quick they didn't get the minute. They didn't get the mention. Russell's mentioning a phrase, no offense. I like no offense better than my bad. I like anything better than my bad. Don't apologize all over the place. You didn't do anything. Most people that say sorry didn't do anything wrong. And most people that did do something wrong don't say sorry. You know, they need to, but they don't. If you mess up, say sorry. Say it. Sincerely apologize. Sorry. Own it and change the behavior, you know. But approaching people saying, I'm not sure if you can, but it's an inferior tone. As if the other person is so important, so busy that you're not worth their time. We're all human beings. There's no need to kneel down, beg for assistance. We do what we do. We do the best we can. There's no need to bow down to people and just unnecessarily just put yourself in a weaker position. Another phrase, would you like to? Yeah. Don't be so wishy-washy. Don't be so iffy. People really do like directness. They don't want to – people don't want to think about everything. You know, and like I said, they could be seeds or bullets, words. These are just words put in order. These are just letters of alphabets. But they can change the world. They are the most powerful thing out there. They're the way that we keep the record of us as a civilization. Something you say could stick with someone else for a lifetime. And it often does. People will come back to you and say things that you don't remember saying, but you said them. You know. And words are they can be forgiven, but they're usually not forgotten. The And when you're in a situation, you're troubled and you have to defend yourself, don't get louder. Don't yell. Use better language. Use better language. Raise your words, not your voice, is a quote I remember from years ago, because rain grows flowers, not thunder. I hate to bother you, but it says the other person has all the power in a relationship, and that what you're doing isn't valuable. It's more than just being polite. It's being submissive, and you can have a lateral relationship with somebody, and you don't have to cow down. You know, well, hate to bother you, bud. You know, when you have a minute, this isn't saying you barge in your boss's office and ask them, you know, where the sweetener is for the coffee, and I want to know now, but you don't have to bow down on everything. I hope that's okay. That's another phrase. You're giving up the authority in the conversation. You know, try using other things. I appreciate the help. Thanks for consideration. Not quite as weak, but they're not overpowering. There's things that we do that we don't talk about politeness anymore. There's sensitivity and insensitivity. Politeness is such a powerful word. It's used so rarely now that it's confused with flirting. Many times, it used to be you'd hold the door, and that was I hold the door for people of both genders. It's a common courtesy. It's a social courtesy. But I've not held the door for people, and I saw an episode of some show where the guy didn't hold the door because the person got mad at them for holding the door before. Then people got mad at him for not holding the door, and that's kind of how I feel sometimes. That you don't know what to do. Everything isn't meant to exploit a situation. Some things are just people acting based on how they were raised, and they don't mean anything by it. When I'm holding a door, it doesn't mean I love you or I hate you. It means I don't want the door to hit you, and it'll only take me a second to prevent that. And I'm just trying to show common courtesy. Inconvenience. I've said it before. We don't even use the word anymore because it minimizes the presumed severity of whatever's happened to us. And we can't be merely inconvenienced. It's got to be a travesty of justice, and it's got to be a grand thing. Everything has to be major. We don't have snowstorms. We have Snowmageddon. You know, everything's got to be so huge that we get numb to it. It's just gotten out of control. What we do with these words, thankful. Not a lot of people talk about what they're thankful for. I asked somebody I know the other day to tell me something that was going good for them, and they stopped speaking. They couldn't come up with anything. And that just made me sad. There's always something positive to talk about. Thank you. Thank you, and you're welcome. Are two core things that should be taught to everyone. It brings back another thing that's not mentioned, civility, basic civility. Civility is not bowing down to others. It's not superiority to others. It's people treating each other justly. And it's got no bearing based on all these things are free. You don't have to, they don't cost anything. It's just behavior. Thank you. You're welcome. It changes the tone, changes the pace of the conversation. We don't talk about wit. We talk about being smart or being fast or being learned. We don't talk about wit. Wit is different. Wit is smart mixed with sassy. It's like sexy, you know. It's not... It's about the mind. It's about